Make sure to pick a poem and get enough practice before the festival, okay? I'll be making pamphlets, so let me know ahead of time what you'll be reciting.
Jeez, I should probably find some other form to recite instead.
That's a fine, too. It doesn't have to be your own. I'm already pleasantly surprised that you're putting in all this effort for the club. Whew, my burrito caught him last time meeting at Chipotle. It makes me really happy, though.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, everyone. I think that's about it for today. I know the festival's coming up. Hey, you skipped my lines, bitch!
You're not allowed to go to Freebirds before we do the festival. We don't want you farting across the stage.
I know the festival's coming up, but let's try to write the poems for tomorrow as well. It's been working out really nicely so far, so I'd like to continue that. As for the festival, we'll finish planning tomorrow, and then we'll have the weekend to prepare. Be prepared! Monday's a big deal.
I can't wait. I can do this. I can do this.
All right. I stand up. There's no way I'll be able to find the same enthusiasm as Sayori and Monica, but I'll do my best to get through it. It's for the sake of the club and impressing Monica. Then I'll have to do my best.
Ready to go, Sayori?
That was my line, but okay.
Okay. Yay! I love just taking the words right out of your mouth.
He's used to that. Look at you two, always going home together. Wait, I did the wrong voice. It's kind of adorable, isn't it?
Jeez, guys, don't make such a big deal out of it.
It must be a little nice, though.
How am I supposed to respond to that?
It's okay, turd burgling horse fetishist. You don't have to say it.
He's not wrong! You killed Wharton. Call the police, I just witnessed the murder.
Okay, I'm better. My fucking... You were great, you hit the reset button. Okay, it's... Frankly, horse fetishes. We need a fucking... We need someone to keep a count, like, a tally on all these fucking names.
Drax can do that in the YouTube version.
Whatever, let's go already.
Well, I'm coming up with more and more as I go along, so...
I mean, this guy had the best part so far. I woke home with Siri once more. Even though it's only been a few days, a lot of things have already changed, but today Siri is being a little quieter than usual on the way home. Hey, Sayori! ...
Sorry, I was spacing out.
Eh, no wonder.
I was thinking about something from earlier. I like how we get to... I mean...
She fumbles with her words.
So, let's just say that one day Yuri asked to walk home with you. That's you.
Eh?
What would you do?
What kind of question is that? You're kind of putting me on the spot here.
Oh, shit.
Choose, bitch!
Now you gotta make a choice, Warden.
Fuck it. So you really think I would ditch you for Yuri?
But She's so beautiful and smart.
Jeez, I already see her in the club every day. Besides, you always seem to really like going home together. Wouldn't just ruin that for you.
You're so silly, Captain Cockbutter. You think about me too much sometimes.
Captain Cockbutter.
I can't even try to compete with these lines.
Captain Cockbutter.
Even when he does just a simple one, it's still good.
Yuri would deserve it if she wanted it so.
So Yuri, I've already made up my mind. I really can't figure out you out sometimes.
Sorry.
So what's the point of speculating something that's never going to happen?
Kind of random note. I just noticed something about this background. There's no manhole on that manhole.
Yeah, there's
that's
not.
That's where you fall down later.
Someone could fall right down that shit.
It's like an elevator to hell.
Here I go!
The worst part is you echoed a little bit.
No, that was intentional.
It's kind of a weird thing for Sierra to care so much about. But I want to respect her and keep her happy. Then again, the festival is only a few days away. So who knows what will happen in that time. Alright.
Start picking words.
Pick a word. Any word.
Fireflies. Fireworks.
You just like fire.
Well, I did make Meanie Bell.
Infallible. Infallible?
Marshmallow.
Infinite. Unrestrained.
I saw you going to Lollipop, you dirty bastard.
Just picking them at random at this point?
Mm-hmm.
Miss Fortune. That's my favorite character in Skullgirls.
After Image.
It's like a Naruto game.
Uncontrollable. Graveyard. I want Bliss and Graveyard to be together. Boop? Is fucking Boop on there?
Yeah.
Motherfucking Boop. Doki Motherfucking Doki Doki.
Lust.
Master.
Oh, Yuri seemed to like it when you picked Lust.
Yep.
Oh, man. I'm the last one here again. Don't worry. I just walked in, too. Oh, wait, sorry.
Apparently, I changed genders and got a new voice.
You did it.
You did it.
Who are you practicing piano again?
Yeah, totally not sucking cocks.
You know you should practice tuba. It fits you better. You must have a lot of determination. Starting this club and now picking a piano.
Well, maybe not determination. But I guess passion. Lots of passion. Remember that the club wouldn't be here if it wasn't for all of us. And I'm super happy that you're all willing to help out for the festival, too.
I can't wait for the festival! It's gonna be great!
Eh? Aren't you complaining about it just yesterday, Natsuki?
Well, yeah! I'm not talking about our part of the festival! But it's the whole day of the school where we get to play and eat all kinds of delicious food!
You sound a bit like Sayori all of a sudden.
Monica, do you usually like fried squid?
Squid? Well, I do like tentacles. That's a pretty specific thing to look forward to, though.
Ah, come on! Are you just saying you don't like squid? I know you're all into that tentacle porn. You of all people!
Well, I didn't say I didn't like it. Besides, what do you mean by you of all people?
Because! It's right in your name! Monica!
Eh? That's not how you say my name, you little bitch. Also, that joke doesn't make sense in translation. Where the fuck's the fourth wall all of a sudden? Never mind. Let's just focus on our events for now, okay?
Okay, so Monica just breaks the fourth wall, apparently.
Mm-hmm. Fine, fine. Your reactions aren't as fun as Yuri's or Sayori's anyways.
Excuse me?
Where is Sayori anyway? Ah, oh, there you are. Go ahead and save. I'll walk over to her. Hey, Sayori. I wave my friend in front of her face.
Eh?
You're spacing out again.
Ah. Sorry. Don't mind me. You can go talk with everyone else.
Is everything all right?
Of course. Why wouldn't it be?
It just feels like you're a little off. Sorry for assuming things.
Jeez, you worry too much about me. I'm fine, see?
Sayori shows me a big smile.
Don't let me distract you from having fun with everyone.
Alright, if you say so. I worriedly glance at Sayori before turning back to everyone else. But the conversation has already dispersed with everyone back at their usual activities. Maybe she asks Monica if she's noticed anything about Sayori recently, since they've been preparing for the festival, as we're spending a lot of time together. I timidly approach Monica, who's shuffling through some papers at her desk.
Warden, you dork, what's up?
Hey, this might sound strange, but have you noticed anything out with Sayori recently?
Anything with her? In what way do you mean?
Maybe I'm reading into it a little bit too much, but she seems a bit downcast today.
Oh, you think so? I can't say I've noticed anything about her.
Monica appears across the room at Sayori, who's idly dragging a rubber eraser up and down her desk.
Maybe there is something on her mind. But I'm surprised I'm not the one asking you, Warden Senpai. You certainly know a lot better than I do.
Yeah, but she's never liked this. She's always talked to me about the things that bothered her. But this time when I ask her, she's being really dismissive. Sorry, I know it's not your problem. I just wanted to ask if you knew anything, so I'll drop it now.
No. It's important to me, too. I mean, I'm also friends with her. And I also care about the well-being of my club members, you know. Maybe I'll try talking to her myself.
Are you sure about that? She seems to be wanting to be left alone.
Are you sure? Maybe she's having a hard time bringing it up with a person of interest.
Person of interest? What do you mean by that?
I'm saying that maybe the thing on her mind is you, Warden, you fucking dork.
Me? How on earth would you come to that conclusion?
Well, bottom basement. I probably shouldn't say too much, but Sayori talks about you more than anything else, you know.
Eh?
She's been so much happier ever since you joined the club. It's like an extra light was turned on inside of her.
What? No way. Suya's always like that. She's always been full of sunshine. She's not any different now than it's always been.
Yeah.
Your Chipotle is acting up again.
You're so funny, Warden. Have you ever thought that maybe you've always seen her as so cheerful? Because that's just how she is when she's around you. Oh, I said too much. I'm sorry. What do I know, anyways? I didn't mean to jump to conclusions, so you should just forget what I said. I'll try to talk to her, so try not to think about it for now.
Alright.
Smile, bitch, smile!
Monica smiles meaningfully. I know she should forget about it, but I already know that I won't be able to get her words out of my head. Monica stands up from her desk, walks over to the room to where Surya is sitting. I watch her kneel down next to Surya and gently talk to her, but she's keeping her voice so quiet I can't hear her from here. I sigh and sit myself down. I know Sayori told me not to worry about her, but and to have fun with everyone else, but that's what I also do when she's behaving like this. Exactly how much do I care about her, that I'm letting this weigh me down so much? Now it feels like I'm the one behaving out of the ordinary. There's nothing I can do besides wait for Monica.
Okay, everyone. After some time passes, Monica... Oh, sorry.
After some time, Monica calls out to the classroom.
Well, why don't we share our poems now?
Before I know it, everything is back to normal. Everyone goes to retrieve their poems, and I do the same. Make contact with Monica and she smiles at me. I wonder what she was talking about with Sayori. Alright. I'm gonna go ahead and save Sayori last, so we'll go as the same order we did last time.
Yeah.
Yuri.
Okay. I'm not reading ellipses.
Well done, gabble-fisted Gimp's apprentice. You've definitely improved your writing over the course of these few days. Has my advice been helpful to you?
Yeah, definitely.
I'm glad. Sharing our writing like this is a lot more fun and rewarding than I anticipated. I need to remember to thank Monica. I think we all felt a little awkward at first. But now it seems like everyone is enjoying sharing their writing and seeing what others think.
I guess I can't really disagree. I was afraid this whole thing would be a chore, but it's a great way for me to spend some personal time with all the girls in the club. But it's been fun getting to know everyone and their writing.
And staring at titties!
I do that anyway. And I guess doing some writing myself.
Well... Have you learned anything about yourself, cock-mongling face-fucker?
That one was kind of weak.
It was.
Well, you know how I like to say that writing is a very personal way to get in touch with yourself. In the end, it doesn't matter if you're a good writer or a bad writer. And even my opinions are just opinions, you know? As always, I believe what's most important is exploring and discovering yourself.
That's comforting, actually. And I'm kind of afraid of disappointing you in some way or another.
Yeah? Why me?
Well, you're always so sophisticated with your writing and have the most advice to share.
Is that so?
Yuri thinks for a good minute.
That must be terrible.
Eh?
For me to become someone whose opinion is fearsome. How unlikable of me.
Yuri, it's not as bad as you're making it sound in your head. I just meant that I respect your opinion.
I see. I'm sorry that I always overthink and come to these sort of conclusions. I'm just a little too used to it.
Overthinking?
Being disliked. I'm the Master of Darkness, for fuck's sake.
Yuri.
What am I saying? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to bring that up. Let's move on.
Alrighty then. Do you want to share your poem now?
No. Okay. Here. Bitch. A marvel millions of years in the making, where the womb of the earth chaotically meets the surface. Under a clear blue sky, an expanse of bliss. But beneath the gray rolling clouds, an endless enigma. The easiest world to get lost in is one where everything can be found. One can only build a sandcastle where the sand is wet. But where the sand is wet, the tide comes. Will it gently lick at your foundations until you give in? Or will a sudden wave send you crashing down in the blink of the eye? Either way, the outcome is the same. Yet we still build sandcastles. I stand where the foam wraps around my ankles, with my toes squishing to the sand. The salty air is therapeutic. The breeze is gentle yet powerful. I sink my toes into the ultimate boundary line, tempted by the foamy tendrils. Turn back, and I abandon my peace to erode at the shore. Get forward, and I return to the earth forevermore.
Nevermore! Nevermore!
I'm aware that the beach is kind of an inane thing to write about. I did my best to take a metaphorical approach to it. Like your sex life. It's a metaphor rather than an actuality.
Okay, that hurts.
You say that like you didn't even want to write about it.
Sorry, I was grabbing a drink.
Yeah.
Oh, you haven't heard? After yesterday, Nutsucky and I, well, it was amusing that we wrote about something similar in such different ways. So Natsuki wanted us to write about the same topic as each other again. I suppose to better compare the differences in our writing styles or thought processes. Anyway, it was her idea, not mine. You can't blame me. Knowing her, it's no surprise she'd want to do something like that. She probably just wants to show off. Show off those tiny, tiny titties of hers. Good God, she's flatter than an ironing board.
It's not the size that matters, it's how you use them.
You could use her to flatten pavement. You don't need a trowel, just use her chest.
How you think I iron my clothes every day?
You have the bust size as a Nanachi has friends.
Do you just stand in the shower and then lay down?
Yes!
It's not like I have a particular interest in her writing style. I just went with her request. But, well, I suppose it's not so bad to write about something simple on occasion. It can be refreshing, you know? It's good for me to calm my thoughts once in a while.
Yeah, I think I agree. Thanks for sharing. And Nutsucky.
Ellipses! Ellipses, that's one's alright. This one's alright.
Alright.
Well, yeah. It doesn't blow me away. And I've been blown before. But there's nothing I really hate about it. It's just not really my style. I mean, that's fine. Come to think of it, this kind of reminds me of Sayori's poem from yesterday.
I think so.
Yeah, well, I guess if you've been friends with her for so long, you might be on the same wavelength.
Speaking of Sayori, I just got followed by someone named Sayori 3.
The other two died.
The other two died, or they formed, or they fused.
They Voltron together.
Even then, they don't have a single brain cell between the three of them.
Anyways, I said that line, so. But you never really struck me as her type.
Syria has a type all of a sudden?
Yeah, it's all positive. Well, I don't know, but honestly, how could someone so, fluffy spend so much time with someone like you?
My type is breathing.
It's like she's dragging around a dead weight, because you're such a bottom.
That was a little unnecessary. But think of it this way, if it wasn't for me, she'd probably just fly away and just like letting go of a balloon. You could say that we take care of each other in our own way.
Whatever it is, I don't get it. Oh yeah, I guess I'm supposed to show you my poem. Here! And look, mine's so much easier to read than Yuri. I'll be your bitch. Your mind is so full of trouble and fears that diminished your wonder over the years. But today I have a special place, a bitch for us to go. A shore reaching beyond your sight, a sea that sparkles with brilliant light. The walls in your mind will melt away before the sunny glow. I'll be the bitch that watches... Whoa. I'll be the bitch that washes your worries away. I'll be the bitch that you daydream about each day. My. I'll be the bitch that makes your heart leap. I'll, in a way you thought had left you long ago. Let's bury your heavy thoughts in a pile of sand. Bathe in sunbeams and hold my hand. Wash your insecurities in the salty sea. And let me see you shine. Let's leave your memories in a footprint trail. See you free in the windy sail. And remember the reasons you're wonderful when you press your lips to mine. I'll be the bitch that washes your worries away. I'll be the bitch that you daydream about each day. I'll be the bitch that makes your heart leap in a way that thought... In a way you thought that left you long ago. But if you let me be your side, your own bitch, your own escape, you'll learn to love yourself again. Ha ha ha!
Writing about yourself again? I could tell by how many times you said bitch.
Yeah! I felt like I kept writing about negative things, so I wanted to write something with a nice message for once. Besides, the bitch is awesome. Kinda hard to write anything negative about the bitch.
You like it when the sand goes up your crack?
Well, Yuri's take on it was a little more solemn.
Well, that's... Jeez, she better not have said anything bad about mine.
It's shit.
After all, she was the one who wanted us to write the same topic.
Garbage pile!
You can really see her doing that too. Making us write about a simple topic and then trying to impress me coming up with something all fancy.
Your writing is doo-doo poo-poo.
Well, it's not like I care!
Haha, you do.
I just did it anyways.
I'm sorry, a coot shit talking in the background.
I mean, I guess mine ended up being kind of metaphorical, too. But then there's nothing wrong with doing that once in a while. At the very least, it was good practice.
Is that what you said about your brother?
That's what I said about the soccer club!